At the start of Tesla's life, Elon Musk only gave it a 10% chance of making it, so he poured his own money into the company.
So I didn't want to ask people, other investors for money if I thought we were going to die.
It's gone from almost being bankrupt to this moment.
Hey everyone. The battery stuff we're going to talk about is truly revolutionary.
Battery Day is the day we saw a roadmap for an affordable electric car. Ever since unveiling its first vehicle, the Roadster, in 2006, Tesla's mission has been to move the world towards sustainable transport.
I think global warming is a very serious issue, and it's something that we have to address, and the only way to address that is to come up with a car that doesn't add carbon emissions to the environment. And I think the way to do that is with electric vehicles.
Over the years, the fleet has expanded, yet there still isn't a model that is cheap enough for everyone to buy, in large part due to the cost of the battery. Electric vehicles are powered by lithium-ion batteries, which contain cobalt, a very expensive material, not to mention some mines are said to exploit child labor. Cobalt is found in the cathode, the structure that holds the cell together. Tesla has now decided to eliminate cobalt and rely on nickel.
And you can see nickel is the cheapest and the highest energy density, and that's why increasing nickel is a goal of ours and really everybody.
And they say that will drive down a price of a car significantly.
We're confident that long term we can design and manufacture a compelling $25,000 electric vehicle. You know, this has always been our dream from the beginning of the company.
But Musk says the car is 3 years away because the battery technology will take a while to get up to scale. If and when it does, there appears to be plans to add it to the future fleet of self-driving taxis called robo-taxis. Battery costs have gone down significantly over the decades, measured by the price per kilowatt hour, a unit of energy commonly used for billing. It's fallen from $1,100 per kilowatt hour in 2010 to $156 in 2019. Many researchers believe getting under $100 per kilowatt hour will make EVs comparable in price to gasoline and diesel-fueled cars. Tesla says its new battery can reduce the kilowatt hour cost by 56%. The battery is also bigger and better. Compared to the current one that powers the Model 3 and Model Y, the new version contains 5 times the amount of energy, 16% more range, and 6 times more power because the tab is removed. The tab is the part that connects the cell with what it's powering. By taking it away, the electrons will travel a shorter distance.
This is a massive breakthrough. Nobody's done it before.
And just like other car companies, Tesla relies on external suppliers to make its batteries. Panasonic, LG, and the Chinese company Contemporary Amperex Technology. But they're feeling the strain as production increases. Tesla will start to build its own batteries in-house at a facility in Fremont, California, which will help bring the cost down as well. Eventually, the production capacity will be many times that of the Gigafactory in Nevada. That factory has a planned capacity of 150 gigawatt hours a year, whereas Tesla aims to make 3,000 gigawatt hours a year by 2030. But in order to achieve the transition to sustainable energy, Musk says the world needs 20 to 25,000 gigawatt hours a year, or 20 to 25 terawatt hours.
But we really are hopeful that other companies will also do what we're doing, and that will make the sustainable future come sooner. We've talked until we're blue in the face. What are we supposed to do?
Regardless of what other companies get up to, Tesla has an ambitious plan of eventually churning out 20 million vehicles annually, or about a quarter of all cars sold globally every year.
Tesla will be absolutely head and shoulders above anyone else in manufacturing. That is our goal.
How does the ICE industry look like in the future?
Well, I don't think there will be an ICE industry long term.
It does remain to be seen how quickly Tesla can deliver on its revolutionary battery, which goes to show that Tesla is not just a car company, but a tech company, hoping to usher in an electric era with the help of better technology. I wanted to spend a minute talking about another kind of technology. You know when you want to watch a video on YouTube, but it says it's not available in your region? What if you could get around that? I recently tried out NordVPN and found it really easy to use. I live in London, UK right now, and if I want to watch a show that's only available in, say, France, with a simple click, I can. It's also great for watching Netflix from different countries. Accessing content is one thing, but more importantly, a VPN is a good way to protect yourself because it means no one can spy on your online activity since the VPN disguises your real IP address. And the cost of protecting your privacy is just the price of a cup of coffee. It's $3.71 a month, plus you get another month free. That's 68% off a regular 2-year plan. All you have to do is go to nordvpn.com/newsthink, which is also in my description. Be sure to use the promo code newsthink. NordVPN works with any device and is compatible with most operating systems. Thank you very much to NordVPN for sponsoring this video. And I have another big thank you as well.
Thanks so much for watching. I'm Cindy Pong. So do you think conventional cars will become obsolete? And if so, how long will that take? Let me know your thoughts. You can leave them in the comment section below. If you like what you saw, give it a like, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. A big shout out goes out to my patrons, including my Patreon producer, Nino Johnny. I will see you all very soon.